Do we have class?
Okay, so good afternoon to all my dear students. I can see there is no need to unmute yourself. There is no need to unmute yourself. You can just message me. And so I hope you all reach safely. Just a minute. ఏం చెప్పారంట మేడం అలౌ చేశారా లేదా కూడా Okay, so we had started our discussion on cardiac cycle. So we looked at the definition of cardiac cycle. Can anybody unmute themselves and tell me what is the definition of cardiac cycle? Anyone can unmute themselves and tell me what is the definition of cardiac cycle?
Cyclic events take place from one heartbeat to other heartbeat.
One heartbeat to the other heartbeat or next heartbeat?
Next heartbeat.
Next heartbeat. Okay. So in the cardiac cycle, I told you that if you look at the cardiac cycle, you have a phase of, you have the events in the atria and the events in the, what are the other events? If one is in the atria, where is the other events taking place?
Ventricles.
Other events is taking place in the ventricles. Okay. So in the atria, you have atrial systole and
atrial diastole.
Ventricles also you have
ventricular systole and ventricular diastole.
Okay. And I told you. Rapmano, class on the Japo. Indian Ramano. And how do you calculate the total duration of the cardiac cycle? How do you calculate the duration of the cardiac cycle? I'm asking you all only.
By inverting the heart rate.
Huh?
So beats per minute, 60 upon beats per minute.
Yeah, cardiac cycle is the reciprocal of the heart rate. Okay. So if heart rate is 75 per minute, so 1 by 75 by 60, that becomes
0.8.
Yeah, 60 by 75. Okay. So thus that comes to roughly 0.8 seconds. So in this 0.8 seconds, what is the duration of atrial systole? Atrial systole is 0.1 seconds.
0.1.
What is the duration of atrial diastole?
0.5 seconds.
Ventricular systole.
0.3 seconds.
Ventricular diastole is
0.5 seconds.
Okay. Now, atrial systole and atrial diastole, there is no problem. Okay. So we look at the ventricular systole. The ventricular systole has got how many phases?
Three phases.
Yeah, and rapid ejection is 0.10 seconds. Yeah, and let me talk. And the ejection phase is 0.15 seconds. So you add up all this, you will get a total duration of 0.3 seconds.
3 seconds.
Right? And then you look at ventricular diastole. Ventricular diastole is slightly more complicated. You have something called as protodiastole. Okay, I'm writing with the mouse. You have something called as protodiastole. Then you have next. What is the next phase?
Isovolumetric relaxation phase.
Then you have
first rapid filling phase.
So you have the first rapid filling phase, then
slow filling phase,
also called as
diastasis.
When I'm talking, please keep quiet. It is also called as diastasis. And then last you have the second rapid filling phase. Second rapid filling phase is also called as atrial systole. Okay. So what are the, what is it? Now you answer. What is the duration of the protodiastole?
0.04
seconds. Okay. So the person who answered, can you write here, ma? Can you write in your screen, on the screen? Do you know how to do that? 0.04 seconds. Isovolumetric relaxation is
0.06 seconds.
No, you keep quiet. Then this is 0.10. This is 0.11. 0.19. And 0.10. This is 0.11. This one. So you add up all this 0.04, 0.06, 0.11, 0.19, and 0.20. 0.10. Kitna hua?
0.5 seconds, sir.
It comes to total duration of 0.5 seconds. Okay. Then I told you some general principles. Whenever we discuss about the cardiac cycle, you have to tell the movements of the valves, what is the position of the valves, what are the pressure changes, what are the volume changes, and whether any sound is being produced or not. Okay, so these things have to be told. What are those things that have to be told? One, the movement of the valves. Okay, so you have the semilunar valves and the atrioventricular valves. See, here, these two, this one and this one, one and two. What is the, what are those valves called as?
Mitral and tricuspid.
Yeah, these two together are called as atrioventricular valves. Okay, so these two valves are called as the, these two valves are called as the inlet valves, because blood flows via them into the ventricles. It cannot go back. When blood tries to go back via these valves, this is going to close, right? Whereas if you look at these two valves, idemo pulmonary valve, idemo aortic valve, these two valves will make, when they open, blood is going to flow out of the ventricle. So they can be also called as outlet valves, outflow valves. The other two can be called as inlet or inflow valves. Okay. So whenever you're talking about the phases of the cardiac cycle, you have to mention about the position of the valves, the pressure changes that take place inside the ventricle, and what are the volume changes, and whether any heart sounds are being produced or not. Okay. Just I'm looking for one thing. Let me see. So when these so what is this diagram called as?
Vigors diagram
is called as Vigors diagram. Right? So it is a comprehensive diagram. It shows everything, most of the things that is needed for our discussion, right? It shows you the pressure changes which are taking place in the aorta. It shows the pressure changes which are taking place in the left ventricle. It also shows the pressure changes that are taking place in the left atrium. And below it shows the volume changes which are taking place in the left ventricle. It also shows the ECG. And it also shows the phonocardiograph, acoustic ante pertaining to sound. Okay, so the phonocardiographic chain, everything is shown in this one single comprehensive diagram, right? So if you see this diagram very carefully, you'll see that when you want to describe any cycle, where to begin, you can begin anywhere. Only thing is, from whichever point you begin, you have to come back and end just before that point. Okay. But for the sake of convenience, where did I begin the discussion on the cardiac cycle in the changes taking place in the ventricles? Anybody?
Atrial system.
Where did I begin my discussion?
Ventricular diastole.
Which part of ventricular diastole is so big, Noma? It is almost 0.5 seconds, is it not? So it's such a long duration, and there are 5 subphases which are there in this ventricular diastole, isn't it? So where did I begin? Where exactly did I begin my discussion on the cardiac?
Isovolumetric relaxation.
I began my discussion.
Isovolumetric relaxation.
Isovolumetric diastole.
Yeah, please. At the end of diastole or beginning of systole? Just at the end of diastole or beginning of systole?
Sir, so, at the end of
So at the end of diastole, what happens? The ventricles are filled up with blood. 120 ml of blood is there in the ventricles. The pressure is just slightly above zero. It will be somewhere between 2 to 4 millimeters of mercury. The red line is the ventricular pressure, left ventricular pressure curve. Okay. In the ECG, you will get the QRS complex. So once the QRS complex happens, the ventricles will begin to contract. When the ventricles will begin to contract, what happens? The left ventricular pressure increases. You can see this here, sharp increase in the left ventricular pressure. And you have to describe what happens as this pressure increases. As this pressure increases, I'll just go back to the diagram here. As the pressure increases, so as this pressure increases, so you see that this ventricle will begin to contract. Okay, so when this ventricle begins to contract, the pressure inside the ventricle will increase. I'm limiting my discussion to which ventricle, ma'am? Left or right?
Left ventricle.
Left ventricle. Okay. So in the left ventricle, pressure begins to rise. This valve is closed. That is, the aortic valve is closed. The pressure inside the left ventricle is still, it is less than the aortic pressure. So blood cannot go in this direction. Pressure inside the ventricle begins to increase and becomes greater than the right left atrial pressure. So what happens? There is a chance that the blood can go back. Can that happen?
No, sir.
Can the blood go back from the left ventricle to the left atrium?
No, sir.
It cannot happen. It should not happen. If it is happening, means there is something wrong in the valve. Okay. So what happens is, as the left ventricular pressure increases and the blood tries to go back into the left atrium, that is prevented by this valve closing. What are these two valves that I'm showing here? This one. And this one,
atrioventricular valves.
Atrioventricular valves. The atrioventricular valves will snap back, they close. So what is going to happen when the atrioventricular valves are going to close? Already semilunar valves are closed. Atrioventricular valves also close. The closure of the atrioventricular valves is going to cause?
Isovolumetric.
The closure of the atrioventricular valves is going to cause
pressure increase,
production of the first heart.
First heart.
Okay, so closure of the atrioventricular valves is going to cause the production of the first heart. So, this one. So you have a QRS complex first. Then you have the pressure change. Then you have the atrioventricular valves closing. That causes the production of the first heart. So now what has happened to the ventricles? Ventricles have become a closed chamber. They are trying to contract. This phase is called as isovolumetric contraction. It will last when, as long as the left ventricular pressure is less than the aortic pressure. See here. So at one point, the left atrial pressure will become more than the, it is going to the left of the aortic pressure curve. Can you see that carefully? Say something.
Yes, sir.
Understand, say?
Yes, sir.
The left atrial pressure is going to the left side. See, this is on this side. That is on the left side. It is more. It is crossing. At this point, it crosses and increases more than the aortic pressure. So the AV valves, the semilunar valves will open and blood is ejected rapidly into the aorta. Okay, so you can see the pressure drop, the volume drop. So when blood is ejected into the aorta, aortic pressure also increases. Okay, and then this will cause the next slow ejection phase. And you can see here at this point what is happening. At this point, we see that the aortic pressure is going below the, left ventricular pressure is going below the aortic pressure. Okay, so the aortic pressure is more, the left ventricular pressure is less. But even then, for some time, the blood continues to go out because of the momentum. Okay, and then you see that at this point, what happens? You have the protodiastole happening. Protodiastole lasts for around 0.04 seconds. And at that point where I have put the circle, the left ventricular pressure is less than the aortic pressure. Blood tries to come back from the aorta into the ventricles. Mm-hmm. Can that happen? Can the blood come back from the aorta into the ventricles? Should not happen.
No, sir. No, sir.
It should flow only unidirectional from ventricle into aorta or from right ventricle into the pulmonary artery. So how is that prevented?
Valves.
Semilunar valves. Semilunar valves. When the semilunar valves close, what is going to happen here?
Second heart valve.
Yeah. Then you have a phase called as isovolumetric relaxation phase.
Yes, sir.
Then that phase will last as long as the left ventricular pressure is higher than the atrial pressure. At this point, you see, the left ventricular pressure is becoming lesser than the left atrial pressure. The AV valves will open and blood starts to rush into the ventricles. You can see the volume increasing. See, at this point, you can see the volume start to increase. Okay, so you have the rapid filling phase. The first rapid filling phase will cause the production of the third heart sound because of the vibrations of the walls of the ventricles and the splashing of the blood inside the half-filled ventricles. And then you have the the atrial systole. Atrial systole is second rapid filling phase that is going to cause the fourth heart sound, right? So just for the sake of revision, I told that again. Now you look at this diagram very carefully. I'll give you some time. I'll give you 2 minutes. You concentrate on the shape of the graph here, and you also concentrate on this pressures here. These values here. You concentrate on this. Okay. Right? I'll just give you 2 minutes time. Quickly look at this. Don't go off to sleep. I know you're all staying at home, eating home food. All missing the mess, isn't it? You all are missing the mess, huh?
No, sir.
Missing the college life?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How much? Only okay, seriously, you don't know what you're missing in life. Okay, it's okay. Right? Okay, now I'll show you one more graph. Tell me. This is also sure. Between what you have seen and what I have shown you here, what is the difference?
That is for left ventricle.
That is the left ventricle. See, this one is the left ventricle. This is
right.
This is the pressure volume changes taking place in the right ventricle. What did you observe?
Pressure.
Who will explain this? Right. Who will explain this? Tell me, Shravanti, na? Tell me, Shravanti.
See,
I have to take this call. I have to take this call. Who will tell me what is this?
Sir, so the left ventricle has to pump into
Can I request you to just identify yourself? You tell your roll number and
sir,
your name.
Sir, this is Deekshita, roll number 118, sir. Deekshita.
Deekshita. Chepama.
Yes, sir. So the left ventricle has to pump the blood into systemic circulation, which is which has high resistance and high pressure. So it has to pump with the high pressure. The right ventricle has to pump into the pulmonary circulation, which is a low pressure, and it is and it has low resistance. So it pumps with a low pressure.
So what exactly can you tell about this? Okay, that but you did you can you comment on this part? Oh, vaccination.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you comment on that?
Yes, sir.
So classroom was better. So what can you comment on that, Deekshita? What I have circled?
Sir, the right ventricle has a maximum pressure of 30 mmHg, sir. Like for the left ventricle, it will be 120.
Yeah. So in terms of fractions, if you would like to comment.
Sir, like 4 times less than the right ventricle.
Yeah, 1/5 of the pressures which are seen in the left ventricle, isn't it? So like you told, that's a good concept that you told, the correct explanation. The left ventricle is pumping into the systemic circulation, which is a high pressure, high resistance, low compliance circulation. Whereas the right ventricle is pumping the blood into the pulmonary circulation, which is a low pressure, low resistance, high compliance circulation. Okay, exactly opposite. That is high pressure, high resistance, low compliance. This is low pressure, low resistance, high compliance. So it need not generate much pressure. So if you remember when we discussed our functional anatomy, we had a discussion on the functional anatomy of the heart. I told you that the left ventricle wall thickness is only is three times more than the wall thickness of the right ventricle. You remember the diagram? Okay, so same reason here, right? So you can see that the pressure, this is almost like this previous one. Okay, so this is almost like this previous graph. Only thing is, it is a smaller version, scaled down version of the pressures which we see in the left ventricle, and it is easier for the right ventricle to pump blood. Okay, so that is one message I would like to give. Now another way of looking at the pressure volume changes in the left ventricle is by drawing what is called as a pressure volume loop. So this is the diagram of the pressure volume loop, where, as you can see very clearly, the left ventricular pressure is written on the vertical axis or y-axis, and the left ventricular volume in ml is written in the horizontal axis. And let me quickly take you through this. Okay, if you have understood the discussion which we had with the Vigors diagram, you'll be able to tell me the answers to the question which I'm going to put forward now. So let us start at this point A, right? So this point A to B, then B to C, what does it represent? You look at what is happening in the volume, and you look at what is happening in the pressure, and tell me quickly. Anybody? What is this A to B and B to C? What does it represent? What is happening to the pressure and what is happening to the volume? Anyone? Hello? Hello.
So the volume, is decreasing. The volume is decreasing. The pressure remains almost constant.
Hey, unka sir chose chepa.
The volume is increasing.
The volume is increasing. Doesn't matter. See, the girl who told first, doesn't matter if you made a mistake. Seriously, it's important that you keep trying. Okay. So you see that at this point, point A, the volume is 50 ml, and at point C, the volume is 120 ml. So from 50 to 120, the volume has increased. Just think back in which phase there is filling and volume increases. It is the diastole. Okay. So A to B is the rapid filling phase. B to C includes the slow filling phase and the second rapid filling phase. Okay. Now comes the important thing. At C, mitral valve closes. What does C to D represent?
Volume constant.
Isovolumetric.
Yeah, who said that?
Sir Bhavna, sir. Isovolumetric contraction. Sir Bhavna, rule number 9. Bhavna Pang.
Okay. So C to D represents isovolumetric contraction. See, you can see that from C to D, the volume is remaining at 120. Straight line it is going up. Pressure is increasing. So remember, aortic valve is already closed. Mitral valve closes. Ventricle becomes a closed chamber. Pressure is increasing, volume is not changing, length of the muscle fiber is not changing. Okay, so C to D represents isovolumetric contraction. At D, the pressure becomes more than the aortic pressure and aortic valve opens. What does D to E represent?
Rapid ejection phase.
Rapid ejection phase. And E to F?
Slow ejection phase.
Yeah. Then at F, the aortic valve closes. What does F to A represent?
Isovolumetric relaxation.
Then you are back to A, and that shows that the cycle is going to repeat itself. Okay, but just because this is easier, when we ask you about the cardiac cycle, you must draw the Wiggers diagram. If you draw this also, you will get extra marks. But drawing only this will not fetch you much marks. Wiggers diagram is a must for cardiac cycle, especially when it is asked as a main question. Okay, so now you draw this quickly. Tandraga rayala. Jaldi jaldi likhna hai. Sikrama varya. Correct, huh? Kerala kutties are there or not there? Reshma is there. Reshma. Hello.
Sir.
Reshma is there.
Hello. Sir, I'm there.
Good. Niyati. She's there? Are sleeping. Nyata is sleeping today. Afternoon siesta. Please let me know when you finish. Raise your hand. I think you have an option of raising hand somewhere. I forgot this whole thing. Madhuriya Reddy raised hand. Huh? So you all raise your hand as and when you start finishing the diagram. Only two raised. Huh? Finished? Oh, I think 28 participants have raised in type unit, right? So, right. So, just you can take one more sentence about this thing and we'll close this topic on the pressure volume changes, right? So, the pressure volume loop, we call this as the pressure volume loop, okay? So, the pressure volume loop shifts to the right in a condition called as systolic dysfunction of the heart. Systolic dysfunction means the heart is generating a lot of pressure, but it is not able to pump out the blood properly. The stroke volume and the cardiac volume both would have decreased. Okay. So in a condition called as systolic dysfunction, the pressure volume loop shifts to the right. So what is the opposite of this statement? What is the opposite of this statement? Hello? Narendra? What is the opposite of the statement I just now told you? Can you hear me? Hello? Hello? Ma, can you all hear me? You can hear me. So I made one statement, is it not? The in a condition called as systolic dysfunction, the pressure volume loop.
Diastolic dysfunction.
Yeah, diastolic dysfunction. The pressure volume loop curve shifts to the left. Okay, in a condition called as diastolic dysfunction, the pressure volume loop shifts to the right. What happened to my video? Why am I not visible? My internet connection is unstable, as usual. So in a condition called as diastolic dysfunction, this pressure volume loop will shift to the left like this. Okay. Systolic dysfunction is where the heart is not able to pump out the blood properly. Okay. Diastolic dysfunction is where the heart is not able to relax properly to receive sufficient blood. Okay. So with this, I'll move on to the next topic. That is, please mute yourself. Yeah. With this, I'll move on to the next topic. That is the heart sounds. Please mute yourself. No, I don't know who is that in the background. You are doing two in one, huh? You're watching a movie and watching the class. It's okay, I'm not bothered. Please don't disturb my class. Yeah. So we'll move on to the next topic, that is heart sounds. Okay. So how many heart sounds are there in total? How many heart sounds are there, ma? Anyone can answer. Totally, how many heart sounds are there, ma? Can you all hear me? Can you all hear me?
Sir, not audible, sir. Audible, sir.
Yeah, now can you hear? Now can you hear me? Are you able to hear me now? raise your hand. You have an option of raising hand. Raise your hand. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me, ma?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So after our discussion on the cardiac cycle, mostly pertaining to the left side, my internet connection seems to be very, very unstable. Anyway, so you all can hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we finished our discussion on the left side of the heart, the cardiac cycle, and we also spoke about the changes in the right side, the pressures being lower, and then we also saw a simpler way of looking at the cardiac cycle, which is called as the pressure volume loop. Okay, so now we'll discuss about the heart sounds. How many heart sounds are there in total?
Four heart sounds.
But in a normal person, you can hear only two with the help
two
of
heart
an
sounds.
Instrument, which is called as the stethoscope. Okay, so there is an instrument called a stethoscope. So with that stethoscope, you can hear only two heart sounds. If with the usual stethoscope you are hearing three or four heart sounds, then it is abnormal. Okay, in a normal person with the stethoscope, you can hear only two heart sounds. And with a special instrument called as, what is the instrument which we use to record the heart sounds?
Graph, sir.
G-R-A-P-H. Oh, first one or second one?
Sir, second one, sir.
Second one. It's the second one which we use to record all the four heart sounds. Okay, so the first heart sound is caused due to closure of the atrioventricular valve. I hope you're writing down this. The first heart sound is caused due to closure of the atrioventricular valves. The second heart sound is caused due to closure of the semilunar valves. The third heart sound is caused due to the first rapid filling sound. Phase. And the fourth heart sound is caused due to the second rapid filling phase, which is nothing but the atrial systole. So what exactly causes the heart sound? What exactly causes the heart sound? It is the turbulent flow of blood, which is the most important vascular component. Valvular component is the vibrations of the valves, vibrations of the walls of the heart. All that will cause, also contribute, but mainly it is the heart sound are caused because of something called as turbulent flow of blood. Okay, heart sounds are caused because of turbulent flow of blood. Right? So, whenever they ask you heart sounds, you should write about all the four heart sounds, what is their cause. And most importantly, you should write about this thing. This is the difference between the first and second heart sound. Okay, I'll just quickly take you through this. Don't be in a hurry to write down, because there are two more points which I want to add. Okay. So if you look at the first heart sound, it is caused due to closure of? First heart sound is caused due to closure of?
AV valves.
And second AV valves. Heart sound
ventricular valves.
Let me talk. See, one is answering, others keep going. Okay. And second heart sound is caused due to?
Semilunar valves.
Okay. Yeah. We can take down that point. Cause. First heart sound, second heart sound. It is due to the closure of the atrioventricular valves. And second heart sound is due to closure of the semilunar valves. And very important, clinically, closure of this AV valves marks the onset of ventricular
systole.
And closure of the semilunar valves and the second heart sound, it marks the onset of ventricular diastole. I had told this in the case. Then character of the first heart sound and character of the second heart sound. Character ante good character, bad character. That is very difficult to define nowadays. What is good and what is bad itself is becoming, what is right and wrong only is becoming blurred. So anyway, so if you look at the character of the first heart sound, the pitch and frequency, it is low pitch, low frequency. Around 30 to 80 per second, compared to the second heart sound, which is a high pitch, high frequency, 150 to 200 the vibrations per second. Okay, and it sounds like the syllable or omnatopoeia, lub, L-U-B-B. And the second heart sound sounds like the syllable or the omnatopoeia, present here is dup. And this is all the students will tell after discussing so much. What is first heart sound? What is second heart sound? Adi lappu sar, idi dabbu sar. Dabbu okati gurtu pettukuntaru. That is not what you have to write all this. Cause, character, low pitch, low frequency, omnatopoeia, lub or syllable lub, and that is high pitch, high frequency, producing a sharp sound. First heart sound produces a loud sound, right? Duration. All this you can't make out with the stethoscope. All this you can make out only by recording a phonocardiogram. Okay, duration, the first heart sound is longer, second heart sound is shorter. The timing is given. It is 0.1 to 0.1 seconds, and that is 0.1 to 0.14 seconds. Where it is heard best? First heart sound is heard best in the mitral and tricuspid auscultatory areas. Second heart sound is heard best in the pulmonary and aortic areas, auscultatory areas. I'll come to that afterwards. So first heart sound is heard best in the mitral and tricuspid auscultatory areas, and second heart sound is heard best in the pulmonary and aortic auscultatory areas. correlation. The first heart sound coincides with the QRS complex, whereas the second heart sound coincides with the R wave on the ECG, and this one is coinciding with the T wave on the ECG. Mainly, this is the ventricular depolarization, that is the ventricular repolarization. So you have written these points till now? Okay. There is one sixth point. Sixth point. What is the sixth point? First heart sound coincides with the carotid pulsation. First heart sound coincides with carotid pulsation. So what is this carotid pulsation? Okay. So I want you all to do whatever it is I'm showing you on the video here. Okay. You pass your hand from your chin down to this part, the thyroid cartilage. Do you feel that? What is the other name for the thyroid cartilage? It is also called as Adam's apple. It is very prominent in male. Did you come to that point? Say something now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So from the thyroid cartilage, you go horizontally till you come to this muscle. What is this muscle?
Sternocleidomastoid
muscle. Okay. So there is a medial border and lateral border. You come to the medial border of the sternocleidomastoid and you keep your thumb there. That is where you will feel the carotid artery pulsation. Very, very strong pulsation. In fact, in movies, especially the Hollywood movies, when somebody collapses, they don't check for the radial pulse. They'll check for the carotid pulsation. Okay. So don't check both at the same time. Your blood supply to the brain will decrease. The one organ which we all steadfastly refusing to use. So blood supply. Okay. So each carotid artery should be checked separately, not at the same time. I repeat, at the thyroid cartilage level, you come horizontally, medial border of the sternocleidomastoid, and keep your thumb there on yourself, neck, you will feel the carotid artery pulsation. Do you all feel this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, congratulations. Congratulations. Today you all felt your own carotid artery pulsation. So nice. Very, very powerful pulsation. It is so powerful that your hand is almost lifted up. Okay, your hand is almost lifted up. Very strong pulsation. In fact, you can compare your radial pulse and check. It is not so powerful. So this is closer to the heart and more blood volume is flowing here. So many other reasons. This is felt very strongly. Okay, so I repeat. Quickly, I'll repeat. First heart sound, the cause, AV valve closure, semilunar valve closure, marks the onset of ventricular systole, marks the onset of ventricular diastole, low pitch, low frequency, high pitch, high frequency, longer duration up to 0.1 seconds, shorter duration 1 to 1.4 seconds. It is heard all over, but mainly in the mitral and tricuspid auscultatory areas. Heard all over the chest, but very well heard in the pulmonary and aortic area. Coincides with the R wave. First heart sound, second heart sound coincides with the T wave. This one, first heart sound coincides with the carotid artery pulsation. Second heart sound does not coincide with the carotid artery pulsation. Anything else I have to tell? Anything else anybody remembers, especially about the second heart sound?
Splitting of heart.
Physiological splitting. Very good. There is no physiological splitting of the first heart sound. There is a physiological splitting of the second heart sound. Physiological splitting is not seen in first heart sound. Physiological splitting is seen in the second heart sound. This is another very important point. So what do you mean by physiological splitting? Buddha sahab, physiological splitting bole to kya hai? What does it mean?
Sir, difference in timings of valves. Aortic and pulmonary.
बुढ़ा साहब नींद में है क्या?
यस सर।
नो सर। आराम से जल्दी जल्दी बोलिए ना बुढ़ा मैडम। What does it mean, ma? Physiological splitting?
Sir, it is difference in timing.
Okay, anybody else can make an attempt? I think she understands, but she is not able to tell it. Story of our lives, kadande.
Sir, I'm Fagun. Can I say?
What is that?
Sir, it's the asynchronous closure of sublunar valve. So the pulmonary valve closes first during inspiration.
Pulmonary valve closes first or aortic valve closes first?
No, sorry, sir. Yeah.
Okay, you remember in the class I told you, first heart sound, how will we write it? You can tell that also here. First heart sound, we write it as M1T1. One for? What does one stand for? What is M and T stand for? అసలే నా హ్యాండ్ రైటింగ్ సూపర్ గా ఉంటుంది. Somebody's mummy is holding them. Please try to sit in a separate room where there is not much of distractions. Okay.
Sir, you are in mute.
Who muted me? So how will you write the second heart sound? You will write it as A2P2. But A2P2 will not be closing together like M1T1. In inspiration especially, you will see that A2 closes first and then P2 closes. This is a normal phenomenon which is seen in all of us. This is called as physiological splitting of the second heart sound. Can anybody tell me the reason for the physiological splitting of the second heart sound? Enduku aitundi? Kyu hota hai?
Sir, after the closure of pulmonary valves, due to more inspiration.
More inspiration. It happens during inspiration, Chandani. Inspiration lo enduku aitundi?
The closing pressure of aortic valve is greater than pulmonary valve.
You read and tell me. Don't start physiology unlimited now. Imagine the physiology. Huda sir. Huda madam. You are muted madam. Jahanavi also muted. Please unmute yourself and talk. I am doing two things which I love. To do. One is I'm having a cup of coffee. Another is I'm teaching my students. So today life ban gaya. Chana happy ga unnanu andi ee roju. I took a class and I was having coffee as I took the class. Cheppandi. Why did you raise your hands? You're not able to hear me? Anybody can tell me the reason?
Sir, during inspiration, the intrathoracic pressure becomes negative. So it's a suction pressure. So venous return to the right atrium increases.
And venous return is more during inspiration. Okay, that is what you're trying to tell. During inspiration, the venous return is more because during inspiration, there is more negativity created inside the thorax. We will read about all this in a greater detail when we talk about the cardiac output. Okay. So for now, you just try to go back, read again. What is the reason for this physiological splitting, right? So with this, we complete our discussion on cardiac cycle, the pressure volume changes, the pressure volume loop, the difference in the pressures in the right side and left side. Left side is more, right side is less. Why we have been discussing that so many times. Then we also looked at a very, 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 very commonly asked question. All of you must know, either in the university exam or Viva or practicals, you will get this. How many heart sounds are there? What are the differences between the first and second heart sound? After discussing so much, only thing I hear will be, first heart sound is lab, second heart sound is dub. That gets me so irritated, you know, makes me so, you should tell all this. The cause, character, duration. Duration you can't make out with the stethoscope, okay? Duration you can make out only with the help of a phonocardiograph. Okay, so now for this, if you're all, can you bear with me for 10 minutes? I had so many disturbances. Can I take another 10, 15 minutes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. If you are lying down, yes, I don't want to go into that. I don't want to imagine also in what positions you are listening to my class. I'm not bothered also. So a couple of things more that we had to do. Okay. So you can make your brother to sit next to you, or somebody in the house, some male person sit next to you, or you yourself, if you're feeling comfortable, you can just feel this. What is this here, this point called as here? If you come on the sternum, at this point, you will feel one elevation. What is that called as? A ridge
angle,
like
of sternal
angle. Sternal angle.
Sternal angle.
Sternal angle. Sternal angle. Also called as?
Lewis angle.
Angle of Lewis. English, you either pronounce
angle of Lewis. Angle of Lewis. Angle of Lewis. Angle of Lewis.
Chalma, chalo. It is called
angle of Lewis.
Ma, angle of Lewis. Yes, is silent. Okay. So, what is the importance of this angle of Lewis?
We have the second.
It's second.
So here, this is the sternal angle or angle of Lewis. The second rib is joining the sternum. Whenever the rib joins, a cartilage will help it to join, okay? So above is the first intercostal space, below is the second intercostal space, you can feel, okay? So the first intercostal space, is above and second intercostal space. On the left side of the sternum, little bit like a 25 paise coin, small coin, little bit it is on the sternum, little bit it is in the intercostal space, you have an area called as aortic pulmonary area. Okay, on the right side you have aortic area, auscultatory area. See, please understand one thing very clearly. Okay, when I say pulmonary area and aortic area and all that, I am not auscultatory area, I am not referring to anatomical location of the heart. I am referring to the point on the chest where the, if you auscultate, the sound of closure of the aortic valve is best heard. See, this is the one, right? So here, this part is the pulmonary area. When I say area, it is not the location of the valve. The valve is not present below. If you auscultate at this point, the sound of closure of the pulmonary valve is best heard. Right side is aortic area. Valves anatomically are present in the other way, okay? And here just below the nipple in males, in the left fifth intercostal space, half an inch medial to the midclavicular line, you have an auscultatory area called as mitral area. So this is aortic, and this is mitral auscultatory area. And at the lower end of the ziphy sternum, slightly towards the left, you have the tricuspid area. There is some controversy about the tricuspid area. Different books are telling lower end of the sternum, some are telling fourth intercostal space. Anyway, left side, third intercostal space, you have aortic, second aortic area. Hello? Yeah, you all are still there?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So, yes, sir. You didn't hear my conversation, na? You heard my conversation?
No, sir.
If you hear, you close your ears.
No, sir.
Huh? Okay, good girls. They're good girls, Mamiro. So, this is the sternal angle. On the left side is the pulmonary area. Please remember this. Left side pulmonary area in the second intercostal space. Right side is aortic area. Left fifth intercostal space, half an inch medial to the midclavicular line is the mitral area. Apex beat is also there. And then the lower end of the CC sternum is the tricuspid area. This is mitral area. Okay. And this is second intercostal space. Somewhere here will be the third intercostal space. You have the second aortic area. Second aortic area. Also called as Erb's point. Erb's area. Okay. So can anybody tell me, when I say auscultatory areas, aortic area or mitral area or pulmonary area or tricuspid area, what exactly am I referring to? Am I referring to the anatomical location of that valve?
No, sir.
No, sir.
What are we referring to? I am referring to a point on the chest. Yeah, a point on the chest where the sound of closure of that valve is best heard. Okay, so that is about the heart sounds. Now, there is something called as jugular venous pressure. Okay. See, if you want to record the pressures inside the heart, what should you do? Heart chambers. What should you do? Hey, come on, fast. If the pressures inside the chambers have to be recorded, what should be done, ma? Unmute yourself, Sarvat.
Sir, catheter.
What catheter? Urinary catheter, what catheter? Be specific.
Urinary catheter. With the pressure. The coronary catheter should be inserted to measure the
heart catheter.
Coronary catheter.
Cardiac catheterization. Simple ga chepestha. Okay. We do one procedure called as cardiac catheterization. This one. Right? So we do this. Now the problem is, when you do the cardiac catheterization from the vein, it is very difficult to go to the left atrium. When you enter from the vein, you have to come from this pulmonary circulation, the veins, enter into the right ventricle, then go into the pulmonary artery, then you'll be going into the lungs. Okay. So their lungs, it is very, very, very narrow. The circulation becomes narrow. So then we record something called as pulmonary capillary wedge pressure. Please read up and tell me what this means. Okay, pulmonary capillary wedge pressure to measure the left atrial pressure. So similarly, if you want to measure the right atrial pressure, you have to put a catheter inside the right atrium and measure the pressure. Are you following me till this point? Have you followed what I'm telling?
Yes, sir.
Any chamber, common sense. Any chamber you want to measure the pressure, you have to put a catheter inside that chamber and record it. Cardiac catheterization is invasive. Okay. It is having so many risks. But if you do something clinically, if you do measure something called as jugular venous pressure, a jugular venous pulse tracing, you can have an indirect method of estimating the right atrial pressure. Right atrial pressure normally is around 4 to 6 millimeters of mercury. Okay. So this right atrial pressure, why are we so worried? In heart failure, right heart failure, jugular venous pressure will increase. there will be hepatomegaly. There will be ascites, means accumulation of fluid in the peritoneal cavity. There will be pedal edema, means accumulation of fluid in the lower limbs, around the ankles, on the medial side, just above the medial malleolus. Okay, so you want to know whether the patient is having right heart failure. So you can measure this jugular venous pressure. Ask him to lie at an angle of 45 degrees. You have a couch in which you can make that person to lie at an angle of 45 degrees, and you can measure the pressure. When you come to the clinicals, if and when you come back, or when you do the clinicals online only, we will try to demonstrate this to you. Okay. Now you can also take a tracing from the jugular venous pulse. So this is how the jugular venous pulse tracing looks like, this one. So you have three positive waves, A wave, C wave, and V wave, and you have two descents, the X descent and the Y descent. This is the Y descent. Please take down this diagram quickly. Jugular venous pulse tracing. I'll give you exactly one more minute to finish it. Very easy, isn't it? All Tirumala hills only. A, C, V. This is X descent. This is Y descent. A wave represents atrial systole. A wave represents atrial systole. Please take down quickly. A wave represents atrial systole. During atrial contraction, some amount of blood will leak into the pulmonary superior and inferior vena cava. During atrial contraction, some amount of blood will leak into the superior and inferior vena cava. That produces this A wave. C wave is due to ventricular contraction. C wave is due to ventricular contraction. C wave is produced when the ventricles contract and the AV valves bulge into the atria. Tricuspid valve bulges into the right atrium. Sorry. And the tricuspid valve bulges into the right atrium.
Sir.
So A wave is due to atrial contraction. C wave is due to ventricular contraction and bulging of the tricuspid valve into the atria. And the V wave is due to venous filling during ventricular diastole. V wave is due to the venous filling during the ventricular diastole. Please find out the reason for the X descent and Y descent and tell me tomorrow. Okay, so with this we complete our discussion on a very, 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 very important topic, cardiac cycle. Cardiac cycle, I told you the definition, I told you the duration. Duration of cardiac cycle is Complete that sentence. Tell me whatever comes to your mind. Doesn't matter. Duration of cardiac cycle is?
Heart rate.
Inversely proportional to heart rate.
Inversely proportional to the heart rate. And when you say 0.8 seconds, inge em cheppal akkada?
For 75.
For a heart rate of 75 beats per minute. Okay. Please keep quiet. Please keep quiet. When you say it is 0.5 seconds, you have to say it is for a duration, a heart rate of 75 beats per minute. Okay. Then I told you systole, atria, systole, diastole, 0.1, 0.7, ventricular systole, diastole, 0.3, 0.5 seconds. And any in the ventricular systole, you have three phases. Ventricular diastole, you have five phases. The duration of each phase. Any phase you talk about the valves, the inflow valve, outflow valve, what is the position, what is the pressure change, what is the volume change, what is the, any heart sounds are produced. Okay. So this diagram is called as a Vickers diagram, which you all have to draw. And then I also showed you another way of looking at the cardiac cycle is by drawing what is called as the pressure volume loop in the left ventricle. And we went through that. I also told you about the heart sounds, how to record the heart sounds, what is the difference between the first and second heart sound and all that. What is a murmur? Please tell me tomorrow. M-U-R, M-U-R. It is murmur or murmur?
Murmur.
M-U-R-N-T. How will you pronounce M-U-R?
Mar.
Mar. M-A-R? Varignava? M-U-R I know is mur. M-U-R is another mur. Murmur kada? Okay, what is a murmur? Please read and tell me. In heart sounds, okay. And then we compared the pressure changes in the right ventricle, that it is very less, and somebody told very nicely what is the reason for that. Then we looked at the auscultatory areas, where they are present and all that. Four auscultatory areas, sometimes there is a fifth one, that is the second aortic area. Then we also looked at, what is the last thing we discuss? Jugular venous pressure.
JVP.
And jugular venous pulse. Okay. So jugular venous pulse is very frequently asked as a short note. The pressure is increased in right heart failure. What is a normal pressure? Please go back and read today. You have a lot of time on your hand. Don't waste your time. As soon as this class is over, close your books. Relax for some time. Close your phones or whatever you're using. Relax for some time. Start reading. Start reading. Anytime the second internal will be announced, anytime the college reopening is going to be announced. Okay. Any doubts you have, please feel free to call me up to evening 7 o'clock. Okay. Please feel free to call me, message me, WhatsApp me. Only doubts. Any doubts about your certificates for scholarship, please contact Mrs. Krishnaveni, PA. Okay. Any other doubts, you contact our Deputy Director, Adi Krishnaya. Don't please, unless it is an emergency, it has to be brought to my notice. Don't call me for these issues. Okay. And tomorrow, I will start a discussion on another very, very important topic in terms of understanding cardiac physiology. In terms of your exams, marks, viva, all that is cardiac output. Okay. So I will give you some five or six definitions. Please find out the definitions and the normal values. First one is stroke volume. Second one is cardiac output. First one is stroke volume. Second one is cardiac output. Stroke volume, cardiac output. End diastolic volume. What is the other one? End systolic volume. Ejection fraction. Cardiac index. And cardiac reserve. Stroke volume, cardiac output, cardiac index, end diastolic volume, end systolic volume, ejection fraction, and cardiac index. Okay. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. Anybody has any doubts? anything you want me to repeat in today's class or till now, anything in cardiac physiology, please feel free to ask me. We'll get doubts only when you start reading. Okay, bye.